right, so now that you've started to track your keywords so that you can see how they're currently ranking for organic visibility, I want to show you how you can also take advantage of our keyword research tool so that you can find better keywords or possibly better performing keywords to actually incorporate into the listing. So let's jump into Sellics and I'll show you exactly where you can do that. Now, you'll want to follow the same steps that you did in order to start tracking your keywords, but this time, instead of clicking on the plus sign, you're going to want to go ahead and actually click on Research New Keywords. And this is where you're going to get this pop-up that will be broken down into three sections. So you'll have seed keywords, suggestions, and relevant keywords. In the seed keywords, you want to go ahead and enter a keyword just to get the search started. So possibly one that you're already using in your title or your bullet points, anything that's directly related to your product, go ahead and enter it in here. So again, if we stick to the same example of our product being a baby blanket, you will want to go ahead and just enter that here and then click on generate suggestions at the bottom. In the middle, you're going to get a bunch of suggestions for you to consider. And you'll notice that if you scroll down, the list can be quite extensive. If you look over, you're also going to see that there are these bars. These bars actually indicate search volume to give you an indication of which keyword is quite popularly searched on Amazon. So the bars will actually range from 0 all the way up to 5. 5 indicating that there is a very high search volume being conducted for that keyword, all the way down to 0, meaning of course that it's not that popular. So the way that we recommend using this section is you want to take a look at the suggestion and first look at how relevant it is to your actual product. You may find that some of these keywords are not directly related to the product, which is why you want to go ahead and be quite picky with the keywords that you do choose here. You don't just necessarily want to go ahead and choose the first 5 or first 10 that you see, because you don't want to run the risk of possibly including these into your listing, but they're not actually related to your product. Hence, you're not going to get any conversions and it can hinder you in the rankings later on. So choosing the best keyword, the most relevant one, is extremely important. And then the second thing that you're going to want to look at is the search volumes. So we recommend picking the keywords that have 3 bars or higher. Those will be the ones in yellow and in red. And that is a good way to filter down this list and, of course, choose the keywords that are most relevant to you. So if we use that 2-step process of 1, how relevant it is, and 2, the search volumes, we can go ahead and quickly pick a couple here that are related to our product that we can potentially add into our listing to optimize it and boost its rankings. So again, my keyword here is a baby blanket, which is my product. And if I'm just going here, I'm going to choose a couple that are related. So let's go ahead and choose swaddle blanket. So definitely related to my product here. And it has the 5 search volume bars, which means a lot of potential customers are searching for this keyword. And then we can go ahead and select, let's say, baby boy blankets. Again, relevant to my product. And it has yellow bars, which means it also has a good search volume. And then finally, let's go ahead and add baby girl blankets. And then from there, you just want to go ahead and add it to relevant keywords, which will add it to the last section. And then finally, add keywords at the bottom. When you click on add keywords at the bottom, this will actually give Sellics the indication to start tracking the keyword for you. So similarly to how you would have added your own keywords for tracking, we will track the first 10 pages on Amazon and let you know if you are appearing within those first 10 pages so that you know which keywords are working for you or where there's room for improvement. Of course, you still have to go into Amazon and incorporate these keywords to give it that extra boost, but I will show you in the next video on how you can also use our tool to figure out which keywords you still need to include. So make sure to stay tuned for that. And that will be all here. You just want to add keywords and that's going to get the tracking started for you. All right, so I hope that you found this video helpful, and make sure to stay tuned for the next video where we're gonna go through the Optimize Keywords tab, which will give you an indication of which keywords you then need to incorporate into your listing based on what you've already started to monitor and track within Sellics. I'll see you all in the next one.